want to explore these coming weeks. You're good. The next one, guys. Next volume. Whoa, we lost it again.
Some people like to climb mountains. I like to build planes in the air.
I grew up wanting to be on a wing, wanting to be up this high.
Sometimes the temperature up at altitude will reach 60 below. It's crisp, it's refreshing.
But you never know what you're going to come across up there. Canyon geese, mallards,
owls.
These people back here, that's why I come to work. That's why I build airplanes in the sky.
We're not just building a plane here. We're building a dream.
I love this job.
I've got a lot of thanks up here. When I look over there and I see that little kid, the look in his eyes, that's all the thanks I need.
Well, if you've been a part of this community for a while, it kind of feels that way, doesn't it? You know, we're really trying to figure this out as we go. And this is a, you know, in the modern world, that was very hard. It was very clear. Churches work this way. If you went to a church, every single church, if you went to a Lutheran church, they all had this book. And worship looked exactly the same way because you knew how to do it. It worked this way and it was set. In this postmodern world, it's a very different thing. And it's not because we're just embracing postmodernism. It's saying, in some ways, it set us free to become more of who God intended us to be in the beginning. But if God's at work in the world, and the world continues to change, and the way God works continues to change, and you know what? It's messy. It's like building a plane is fine. Now there's a goal. You're trying to get someplace, right? And we're, you know, we know what it's about, that God is in the world, making the world more like God intends it, about heaven coming down to earth. I mean, that's what Jesus prayed. You know, he says, when you pray, you say, our Father in heaven, you know, your name is holy, may your will be done on earth in the same way it's done. God wants to be about changing this world, but how that looks gets kind of messy. There's some things we want to explore, I think, to help us, and it's not just to give us answers, to say, this is the only way, but I think these are some central things that help us in that journey. We could. One, we want to identify with Jesus, right? We want to be about practicing the way of Jesus. If you look at the stories of Jesus, he wasn't just about this head knowledge of what you had to believe and the right prayer to pray. Jesus was out in the world connecting with people. He had this mission, this focus he was about. Now about God's kingdom has come near. We want to explore what that looks like. Two, we're going to talk about transforming secular space. Where have we worshipped in the past few years? We've been in a movie theater. We're here at the high school bowl from the cafeteria. Today we're in the band room. But it's not just about Sunday morning worship, although we want to transform that to say, you know, God is here in this space, just like he might be in any of those other church buildings. But all through the week, you know, we can gather together in other places to explore spirituality. It might be out in a restaurant. It could be in our homes. Or just wherever we are, at work, at play, with our families, all those places are places God is at, and we want to see that. It's going to be about living as community, all right? You know, a lot of times with church, and I'm not trying to be critical because I've been there, is that church becomes just about Sunday morning, and it's not really community. I mean, how many people have been to a church that you might have been a part of for a while, and you didn't even know most of the folks' names, right? That you didn't have anybody you ever really talked about those deep spiritual things, that's why you came to that community in the first place. So we want to live as community. And these three things, I think, are very central. But if these things are central, and I think that we really have tried to be about this, not that any of us live it perfectly, but because of these three things, we also want to be about welcoming the stranger. You look around you, we're pretty strange, aren't we? So we want to welcome everybody, no matter how strange they are. Right? In the Bible, this is very important, and our culture has struggled with this. Not trying to get any kind of policy, but when we talk about immigration, people are different, and we have a hard time with that. You know, the Old Testament, especially, is very clear. You know, people who were the Israelites, they came from a different place to a new land and said, you know what? You knew what it was like to be strangers? You need to welcome strangers. So what does that look like? Serve with generosity. You know, a lot of times in our world, we're taught to hold on, you know, you don't want to lose it. But God is about generosity, about pointing things out, and we want to be generous. Participate as producers. I had a struggle with what that meant at first as we wrestled with this and looking at this and many churches exploring the journey we have, but saying, one, it's not about being consumers, right? We're in a culture where it's about what? What you consume. So then if church is like that, church is supposed to do what? Feed you so you can consume it, right? And if you're not getting fed, then it's not for you. Well, no, if we're producers, it's saying, we have gifts God has given for this world to change to be more like what God intends it to be. And we're not just here just to get fed, we also have gifts to share. We need to be about that. You know, not just taking in, but giving out. To be created, to create as created beings. We read this story a few months ago in Genesis, where God creates Adam and Eve. They're in the garden. It says there weren't any plants yet in the ground because, one, God hadn't sent the rain, so God's in this. But also it says because there was no one to till the ground. There was no one, you know, to weed and do the things that needed to be done. Saying, God's about this, and He created us. We're created in God's image, but we're also called to help create this world God is making. So we need to be about that. And then to lead as a body. And I'm going to explore this more, but to say, you know, it's not just me as an individual. We need to be a community. You know, we need to be connected in. And we were talking about AA, I think, as a good example of this, that, you know, the community is essential, that no one grows without community. So we just talk about us as individuals, and then things die. We need to be about a whole community leading together and listening to what God is saying to us. The last one is to take part in spiritual activities. And it's that, you know, that the realm of the spiritual, even though it touches everything, we've been taught that it's only in a certain place. And we need to be able to explore that. We need others to help us in that journey. It's part of why we're gathering, you know, a small group of us that we meet each week. So I want to invite each of you to explore that, whether in a group of us together or just sitting down with me or any of us over coffee. We need to explore this, that life is spiritual, that there isn't just the sacred and secular, that everything is spiritual. We want to explore that together. I've used a lot of time today. I hope you'll forgive me. I'm sorry about that. But, you know, we don't have to take down afterwards, so probably mostly, so that's kind of nice. But I want to invite you to be part of this journey, and I want to invite you to invite others too, because I think a lot of people are really struggling with some of these things. A lot of people are hungry for a God who enters the world that they're in, not just the world that was. And I'm tired of churches telling them it has to be this way. It's a good place where we can ask questions, but to believe that God is really out there in the world, transforming the world to be more like what God intends it to be. And then it's something that we're all hungry for, even if we don't see it. And let's enter that journey together with prayer. You can bow your heads, you can raise your hands, you can even do as the Hebrews did and fall on your face if you really want to pray, but we're going to pray. Jesus said, God, with us, we ask right now that you would open our eyes to see you, that you are here incarnate, that you are in flesh among us, that you dwell within us, and so we too, by your presence in the world, called to help create the world that you're intending to be, that you invite us to live, Jesus, in your way, in the way that you did. And we ask that you would help us to do this as a community, to remember, welcome those who are strangers, to be generous people, to live in the way you did, and to be open to wherever you lead us. And we ask that you might be with those now who are hungering to know this too, to be in a place where it's okay to have questions, to know that we're in a journey, that we haven't reached all the answers yet, and that's to wrestle with that is what you were about to. And so be with us in this journey. Touch the lives of others outside, and help us too to be a means of them knowing you in all that we do in all our lives. Know your presence. We ask this in Jesus' name. And all God's people say. You know, at the end of our gathering, we always kind of finish with slides. And these aren't just the announcements. This is actually, in many ways, an invitation of how we can continue to live out that everything is sacred, that God's already out there. And so we've been exploring this. And next week, we'll explore too. Next week, next slide, if we could. We'll be exploring identifying with Jesus. What does it look like? To seek to be more like what Jesus was about. And it'll be week two in our new series, Reclaiming Jesus' Message for Everyone. And that's really what we want to be about.